Hey guys, I've had a couple of range extenders donated to me, and I figured we'd just do a quick video, see what they look like on the inside. These are Smart / RG. These retail for about $145 each, and the theory is, they say on their website anyway, is you basically put your network card, plug your network into there, and it goes, and then the other one goes to your router. And it uses the house electrical wiring to basically network them together. I took the screws out of the one. I'm going to pull it apart. I wouldn't even be surprised if it just has an antenna and they communicate through each device. But if it does use the actual electrical, I'll be surprised. Anyway, I figured I'd do a video and pull it apart. Just see what it looks like on the inside. Front. And you got this module here. This is your power supply. And it is fused. I don't see an antenna on this. Not much to it, really. So there's your AC lines there, and it looks like it's using the ground, as you know the website says. I wish I could pull this out, but I don't want to destroy it. It's stuck on something. But you can see on the side there's two coils there. They're also for surge protection. I really doubt they're actual antennas itself. So yeah, it's as they had posted. It is basically it's using the ground as an antenna. It should be interesting how quickly it is. Like if I set one of these up down here on my server, and I'll set one up on my router upstairs, two floors up, and we'll see how well it works. We had a problem. Okay, so this one I had to repair. There's a little button on the end that you push to sync them both. What it does is it basically makes a key or whatever, and they both shake hands with each other, which they're doing now. This one over here has got the data light on as well. They're saying on the instructions on the website to have them in the same room when you're setting them up. Obviously it makes sense. You wouldn't have to go up and downstairs. So that was the issue with that one. The button is still clicks, but it's not making a connection. So I ran a wire and basically just touched the wires together to get it to set up. But it's up and running now. As you can see, I've got all three lights. Solid data light. Well, what I'm going to do now is take it upstairs and show you how weak it gets. It goes from 100 MIPS down to maybe 20 or 10. The data light will flash red, but it still works. So I don't know if it's what it's saying here. Sorry about the monitor, it's on its way out. So we'll disconnect the Wi-Fi. Go out of that, and it just says unidentified network, no internet. So we'll take it upstairs and plug it in and see what happens. Now hopefully this works. Let's plug it in. Lock the light so you can see it better. Yeah, so there it is linking now. Like at first I thought that was actually it's working better this time. I'm getting all green lights. We might have something working downstairs. Let's try it out. Yeah, the one down here is still red. But like I said, when you go to the instructions on it, how to set it up. Oh, duh, can't be reached, obviously. It says connected. Yeah, it's working. Not too sure why the website I had up isn't coming up, but it is working. It's actually pretty fast. I can see why they're worth $140 a piece. That is way better than doing antenna. Wow. Good enough. It's still better than the network card I have, so I'm going to leave it actually and set it up so I can use it full time. But yeah, if you're having any issues with them, if you can't get the link up after holding that button for 2 seconds, more than likely the button's gone bad. Like I said, I jumpered it for now. I'll probably take the button off and swap it out with another one before I put it back together. Later, guys.